Indian Tiger. Next, the internal characteristic feature of the amphibia. Yes, what are they? Internal characteristics. First one, the digestive system. The complete digestive system. The digestive system associated with the associated glands. The digestive system, there most of the organisms are have a digestive system. But there is a lacking of the associated gland. But in this file, in this class, stocks are begin to associated with glands. So that is called complete digestive system. Digestive system is complete, well developed. Complete and well developed means associated glands. Well developed system and associated along with the associated glands. Which one associated glands? The associated glands are nothing but which are essential for during nothing but these glands are essential for make converts into complex food converts into simple substances. Those glands are called as associated glands. Clear. Digestive system. Clear. These are habit. Which one? These are carnivorous in nature. Carnivorous in nature. Larvas are herbivorous. Larvas are herbivorous. And what is that? So the just to think once. So the larva is formed the after the mating, after the these are male gamete, these are female gamete, both are together to formation of a zygote is formed. So the zygote to larva is formed. So the larva to adult is formed. How the larva converts into adult? The larva is a very microscopic in nature. How these are converts into adult one? Why? Because these are shown a metamorphosis. This the process is known as a meta means multi, morphosis means changes. Multiple changes are there in larva and converts into adult one. So the metamorphosis process is completely under controlled by thyroxine. Which hormone? Thyroxine hormone. The metamorphosis activities. The metamorphosis is under controlled by the thyroxine. So these are known as a herbivorous. Clear. So, what is associated glands? What are the associated glands? Salivary glands, very important. Salivary glands are associated glands for the digestion of the food. And what is that? Gastric glands, HCl, hydrochloric acid. Gastric glands. And hepatic glands. Hepatic glands. Hepatic glands. And what is that? Hepatic glands are next one. Pancreatic glands, very important. Next one, digestion, respiration. Which type of respiration? So there is during an aquatic condition, there is an aquatic region. So these are there in aquatic region. So the organisms are shown skin respiration. When it is comes into terrestrial, shown pulmonary respiration. So there is a shown three different type of, don't get confused, these are shown three types of respiration. We know that only two, but additionally is one is there, ready to listen. First one is in aquatic condition, these are shown skin respiration. I will give the more surprises to you. Aquatic is shown skin respiration. The terrestrial, there is a two types of respiration. First one is pulmonary, nothing but lungs respiration. Pulmonary respiration. Or lungs respiration. Commonly is a lungs respiration. Clear. The next one is buccal pharyngeal respiration. Buccal pharyngeal respiration. The two terrestrial, there is a two types of respiration. Okay, there is a complete three types of respiration was takes place by the individual, by organisms. So digestion, respiration, circulation. Very important, circulation. These are shown closed type of circulation. Closed type of circulation. And these are the, what is that? The heart is located in the ventral side of the body. Ventral sides of the body. And this heart containing three chambers. How many? Three chambers are there. There is a three-chambered heart. Three-chambered heart. What are they? Two auricles and one ventricle. Two auricles and one ventricle. Two auricles and ventricle. I will give complete information. Okay, I will give the complete information about all classes, all phylums. Listen carefully first. You are listen carefully, interest, concentration on these topics. The card, what is that? What is the auricle, two auricles and one ventricle is there. And next one, these are contain venous heart. Is it containing which type of heart? Venous heart, nothing but oxygenated blood and deoxygenated blood, both are together to formation of a contaminated blood, that is called as a venous heart is there. Clear? So these amphibians all are cold-blooded organisms. Cold-blooded nothing but pi kilothermic. Pi kilo means less. Thermic means heat. There is a very less heat, so these are called as a pi kilothermic organisms. Very important. This is containing blood pigment. So what are they? Blood pigment is hemoglobin. And the RBC is a nucleus. What is that? Ovoid nucleus. Nucleus, the RBC containing ovoid nucleus. In amphibians consistent of ovoid nucleus, but then in human beings, in RBC there is absence of nucleus. In human beings, the RBC there is no nucleus. This RBC, there is no nucleus. There is no nucleus in human beings. But in amphibia, they are containing one of the large ovoid nucleus is present. Clear? This is a circulation. Next one, the two auricles and ventricles, and along with one of the spilangium and tylangium is there. Spilangiums are there. These are associated chambers. Next one, circulation, respiration, digestion, circulation. Next one, nervous system, the very well developed of central nervous system, peripheral nervous system. Central nervous system covered by nothing, brain is covered by two membranes are known as a pia mater and dura mater. And very, very important, these are containing 10 cranial nerves are present. Only 10, not 12, only 10 cranial nerves are present. How many? 10 cranial nerves are there. Next one, circulation, nervous system, respiration, excretion, reproduction. Excretion, very important, excretion. So there is shown two different type of excretions. What are they? There is an aquatic condition. The amphibians, they are in the aquatic. So these are excretion of the uric acid. But the larvae are excretion of ammonia. When it is comes into terrestrial, it is excretion of the urea. How many? There is a three excretory products. Amphibians excretes. Three excretory products. What are they? First one is there is during in aquatic condition in adult. Adult during in aquatic condition it excretes which one? Uric acid. Larva in aquatic it is excretion of ammonia. The adult one is in adult one is in terrestrial. Terrestrial, it is excretion of urea. Clear? So how many excretory products? Three excretory products. How many? There is a three excretory products are excreted by the amphibians according to their habitation. According to their habitation, these excretes three different type of excretory products. Excretion through the excretory organ. Excretory organs are metanephridians are nothing but kidneys. Excretion through the metanephridia. Nephridia are kidney. Metanephridians are kidneys. These are excretion through the which one? Yes, that one. Next one, reproduction. The reproductive system, it is very well developed reproduction. So these are shown unisexual. Unisexual forms. Fertilization takes place in outside of the body. The development is indirect development. The larva is present. Okay, so the larva is tadpole larva. We know that everything. What is that? First one, reproduction is unisexual. First one is unisexual form. External fertilization. Are you clear? External fertilization. Yes or no? Yes. External fertilization. Fertilization. External fertilization takes place. The development is indirect development. Why? Because there is a larva is present. Indirect. Indirect development. Why? Because there is a. What is that? One of the larva is present. The larva is. Which larva? Tadpole larva. Tadpole larva. After completion of their free swimming nature. These are converted into new adult one by the mechanism is known as metamorphosis. Next one, very very important. Yes? Anyone? Any doubt? Yes. Yes, this one very very important of these amphibians. What is that? Amphibians are only developing of renal portal system. Very very important. Note down everyone to the box. The renal portal system is very well developed. Very well developed in amphibians. Sir, what is the renal portal system? So what is the, we know that we have a doubt. What is the renal portal system? Renal nothing but kidney, portal system nothing but veins. The renal portal nothing but the kidneys carries deoxygenated blood from their body and filtration process was occur. Filtration takes place in the renal region, so that is called as a renal portal system. So these are maintained osmoregulation by the glomerular filtration. The maintain very very important. These are maintain osmoregulation through the glomerular filtration. Nothing but the filtration takes place in the glomerular region. This is a Bowman's capsule. This is known as a glomerular. Okay, the glomerular region, there is a filtration process take place. And very very important is, so if it is take the more amount of the food, sufficient food, so the body is filled with more amount of the glycogen. The glycogen is converted into fatty acids or lipids. So the organisms are what we do. The organisms are wants to be. They take a sleep. They wants to be take a long period of the sleep. That is called as a hibernation. Okay. The amphibians are they're getting more amount of the food. The storage of the more amount of the food is the glycogen or fatty acid region in their body, they need more, they need what they need? They need sleep. Okay, they need sleep. That sleep is known as a hibernation. Very important, the sleep is known as a hibernation. The amphibians are shown two different type of hibernations. Amphibians are shown how many? Two different type of hibernations. First one is summer sleep and winter sleep. The hibernation is nothing but the organisms are getting more energy. So this one to be sleep. Sleep is known as a sleeping. Is known as a hibernation. Sleeping is known as a sleeping. It can be two types of sleeps are there. Winter sleep and summer sleep. Winter sleep and summer sleep. The winter sleep is called as a hibernation. The summer sleep is called as a avestivian. Avestivian. The winter sleep is called as a hibernation. The winter sleep is called as a avestivation. The winter sleep is called as a hibernation. The summer sleep is called as a avestivation. So don't get confused. They are asking, what is the avestivation? What is the hibernation? Hibernation is nothing but the organisms want to be sleep. They are ready to sleep in during in winter season. That is called as a, what is that, hibernation. They are during in, what is that, summer. So they sleeping is known as a avestivation. Are you clear? I hope everyone is understood. Thank you.